So I've also received updates from a lot of participants. Even it is available in the questions tab. So apparently the bulk upload of questions is actually possible in Moodle. So really sorry that I had given this, I didn't know about this earlier. So this is actually an evidence of actual practitioners giving me inputs regarding specific usage of tool. And this is why I'm saying that I am also learning in this entire process. So currently what we'll do is we'll restart the lab activity, but along with that there are few notifications regarding lab activity. So the lab activity is that you will be continuing with the question collection and providing of answers, but there are some additional instructions for you regarding this particular lab activity. So the activity is the same. You have started off with this activity and I believe you would have reached at least till pair. So today you will have to complete the pair and solo phase, individually consolidate all the answers in your own website as well. So one guideline that I would give all the remote centers, it is always good to have a shared Google Doc or a shared document where everyone is populating the answers that they are giving or the questions that they want to ask. So if you structure it like that, it will be easier both for the RCC to consolidate all the queries and all the answers that have been posted. Regarding the comment issue in Padlet, I see that some of the users have deleted the post itself. So it could be one reason, but I didn't see any participant deleting a comment, nor is any nor did I see any update saying that within the Padlet site saying that the comments will get deleted every day. So there are no settings like that. The site is, whoever has the link will have access to the Padlet, and so only if a author deletes a comment, then only it gets deleted. Otherwise, the comment will still remain over there. I'll be further exploring this, but till now, so I haven't seen any queries that is being posted in the community where the comments, there is an issue cited as comments getting deleted. What I would additionally suggest is that when you create the page questions asked, you can provide a comment feature within WordPress itself so that other participants can comment on the questions. So the RC, pairs or the individual RC participants who visit the RC website, they will be able to answer the query in that page itself. And I also see that not all RCs have posted their WordPress webpage. I would request all RCs to start posting their webpage as Padlet posts. Do not worry if you see that as an anonymous, the name anonymous coming over here. You can log into Padlet, and if you want a RC ID displayed, you can create a login within the Padlet. Regarding lab assignment quizzes, so I just checked with the system team. They have advised me to release the lab assignment quiz tomorrow afternoon. So we'll be releasing the lab assignment quiz tomorrow at 12:30 p.m. and the due date is the Sunday, that is 24th September at midnight. Please note that the lab assignment quiz will be based on the lab activity that you do across the week. There was also a question regarding lab activity due dates. The RCs can continue the lab activity till 24th September. So individual participants, they can go through more remote center, the questions posed by more remote centers, and it is always advised that if somebody has already responded to some of the queries, choose a different RC's web page so that you can cover maximum RCs in this particular process. What we are going to do is whichever RC posts their web page, the WordPress web page in the Padlet, we'll be adding all those RC's web page in our FDP ICT WordPress web page. So this, at the end of this week, we will consolidate all these WordPress web pages and we will be putting up this in our the FTP's WordPress web page. So people who want, and we'll be clearly mentioning the most active RCs and others in that particular web page. We'll be posting that as a blog post in the in our WordPress web page. Why should an RC do a lab activity? First and foremost, you will have, this is actually a crowdsourcing activity to build the knowledge base about various tools. So technology is changing very rapidly, and it is important that we keep abreast with all the changes. So it is important now for so it is very difficult for one individual to explore all the features of a particular technology tool. So with constant practice, you will see a lot of issues, lot of regular queries that are coming up. All these can get answered through such a crowdsourcing activity. Additionally, within IIT Bombay, we have a system of rating RCs based on the their performance. So currently we look at how active they are, what is their audio video quality, and what is their attendance. All those things are being considered in the current rating. So what we are proposing is these crowdsourcing activities, specifically in FDPs, where RCs contribute to the knowledge base, we will look at RC's contribution and add a particular portion, a maximum of 2 rating points will be added to the RC. So if an RC as a whole provides more than 50 answers, then you will get 2 rating points. If there are more than 25 answers coming from an RC, but it is less than 50, we'll add 1 rating point. Between 10 and 25, you will get 0.5 rating point. This is because typically in an RC, the strength varies from 3 to 4 participants to more than 100 participants. So even the lower attending RCs can get a lot by such an activity. So whenever the RC rating increases, and let's say it is being put as a collaboration component, so when the next time the FDP comes in, we will definitely be giving you more weightage, because we know that as an RC, you contribute to the knowledge base, you participate in collaborative activities more than which is visible from your answers and your participation. Okay, so a little bit about open education resource activity in this particular FDP. So the open education resource or OER creation activity is the final group project in this particular FDP. This will be released, the videos for this will be released in week 3, that is 28th September. And what is going to happen is, over a period of 2 to 3 weeks, a group of people would be coming together and creating an open educational resource. So a group means it will be a team. So we will consider that as a team, and ideally the team should be formed within a cohort. So you have each of the participant within the FDP is put into different cohorts. So look into the members from the same cohort can form a team. A team will have not more than 3 members. So once the team is being created, then they will look into creation of an open educational resource, which could be, what is meant by an open educational resource? Any resource like a flipped classroom lesson design, or a Moodle course, or a video or screencast for AV usage in vernacular language, or any resource that can be used by academic community, which is in Creative Commons. Those resources, we call them as open educational resources. A detailed email will be sent to the mentors and mentees by 21st September. All your mentors had undergone this OER creation activity last year. So they will have more information and they will have more clarification regarding this entire OER process. The AVU interactions of mentors and mentees in this particular FDP will start from 21st September. The slots will be updated shortly, And we are going to provide three interaction slots. So the mentor and mentee can decide convenient slots, and we are just requesting you to do at least one interaction with your mentor. So out of these three, even if you attend one interaction with your mentee and clarify your doubts, that is good enough. So we are providing three convenient slots. Now there were issues, some issues in the previous FDP where people said that the mentor was not present for more amount of time. So what we are suggesting is the mentor and mentees can, through email or some other, let's say the mentors can create a Google survey form once the slots are released, and then they can pick convenient slots in within these three where they will interact with the mentee. So AVU interaction, by interaction, it does not mean that you have to compulsorily attend all AVU interactions. Suppose that there is a bandwidth issue, the mentor and mentee can decide on appropriate interaction mechanism. So let's say a group of mentees are available and AVU is not, they are unable to come into the scheduled AVU slot. So they can choose other mechanisms in discussion with the mentor. So let's say if they say that we will interact through email, even that is fine. So you can all email your mentor and clarify your doubts, but having that physical presence would add much more, will give you more clarity. So we recommend that you try to attend one of the AVU interaction slots. If AVU is not possible, you can decide on appropriate video interaction tools like Skype or Google Hangouts, whichever is convenient for both of you. So this decision has to be taken by both the mentor and the mentee. From our side, we are providing this slot system just like what we did last time. Unfortunately, since it is very difficult to handle the logistics, it has to be a forced continuous slot system. We cannot have too much of a flexibility in changing the slots. However, please note that you need to do only at least one interaction out of the three slots that we provide you. So all of you can continue with the lab activity where you will, what I'll do is I'll share the slide now to you in the Padlet. So I'll upload this particular slide in Padlet so that all of you can download it from there. I'm just uploading the slides in the Padlet right now. Okay, the instructions have been uploaded in Padlet. Now the pairing of OER, that is a separate activity. Do not confuse it with the lab activity. OER creation activity is the team project in this particular FDP. A team is actually a cohort. So like now in the lab activity, the team was the entire RC. So similarly, the virtual team that we have are the cohorts. So within your cohort, you will have to find two other members and decide on working on a single project. So a detailed email will be sent to all participants and the mentors regarding guidelines of OER team formation. So over the period of the next 1.5 week, you can think about the team formation and decide on the type of OERs that you want to create as a team. The OER creation videos, the guidelines on OER creation will come in the third week of this particular course, which starts on 28th September. The Padlet link is the same that you had yesterday. Just paste the link of the Padlet in the chat. So it is put as a lab session 2. The PDF has been put as lab session 2. So it is available over here. So I see that a lot of people are posting lot of so the RC ID I have updated as RC 1000, IIT Bombay, slides for lab session day 2. Okay, so if you actually look into the Padlet right now, you can see that I have posted it as RC 1000, IIT Bombay, slides for lab session day 2. So here I have given the instruction, you will have to continue with the pair and solo phase of lab activity given yesterday, and the mentor mentee slots will start from Thursday. OER creation activity is a team project, form teams within a cohort. The detailed instructions will be sent to you. So a separate email will come to you, both mentors and mentees, where we will from the course support, where we will give specific instructions on how to form a team and how to create an OER. So I'll just answer two queries from so I'm going into the questions tab where you had posted lot of queries. I'll just answer the top 5 queries over here. Screencast-O-Matic allows video recording of 15 minutes only. What are other options to increase recording time? This is from RC1059. There are no other free options for increasing time. You have to go for their paid plan. Anna University of Technology, Madurai. What is the necessity of private file upload? So this was asked today morning. Okay, there is a question that NMIMS from Shirpur. Sir, don't you think that merely taking the poll would not give a clear picture of understanding of concept, as answer chosen might just be a guess? It would be better to ask for justification as well as for choice. So yes, polls do not actually reflect conceptual understanding, but if the questions are designed in such a way that the concepts are discussed, then you go for the peer discussion and allow for changing of options in the revote, then you will come to know whether they have got the correct conceptual understanding. So polls also as a strategy has to be used very carefully. So if polls are used along with peer instruction, then it will give you more clarity on whether the students are conceptually strong. There is another question. Is it mandatory to create videos in vernacular language? No, need not. But however, if there is a large proportion of students from vernacular language, it is always better that you give it in vernacular language first, so that students will understand. So there is a question, how Padlet is different from a discussion forum? So more or less, it's like a more interactive discussion forum. But over here, you have additional facilities of uploading media and files. And you can take a dump of the Padlet. So if you are an owner, then you can take a dump of it and export it into a PDF or a Excel or in CSV format. Lot of functionalities are available within Padlet, unlike a traditional discussion forum. There is a question from 1088. In this FDP, we have learnt about flip classroom approach, active learning strategies, significance of collaboration, and peer review assessment. All these concepts can make the teaching learning process more effective and enjoyable. So my concern is it possible to frame a policy decision by apex body like MHRD to incorporate educational technology in teaching learning mandatory to achieve educational revolution within India? Now, yes, it is possible, and I think MHRD and AICT are bringing in so all these efforts. So why AICT is supporting an FDP like this is because so that more number of teachers would be trained in it. Now, before creating any policy, it is important that the policy is understood and is actually realizable. Now, we have around close to 3.5 lakh teachers within higher education itself. Unless and until all these teachers get a basic training, it will be difficult for the apex body to say that all these technologies need to be mandatorily incorporated or give directions to institutes saying that you need to incorporate better educational technology practices. But I think in NBA accreditation and other things, they are having certain points for innovative teaching learning practices and use of technology, collaboration, the community building, etc. So they are, this is one of those strategies that they are using, and it is actually a multi-pronged approach. Comments regarding Padlet. So are there any criteria to select correct strategy? Just see what the strategy is able to do and align it to the objectives, what you want to achieve, and will the strategy actually help in achieving it. That's all. Other than that, there are no fixed criteria, and also the time duration might be an important metric that you want to additionally think about. Okay, so RC1173 Tyagarajar College has asked, in the RC WordPress site answers provided page, what contents we need to add? There is some more confusion regarding that. So the answers provided, so the WordPress web page is about your RC and the answers provided by your RC. So all the participants within the RC, if they have provided answers to multiple RC's questions, then you should all consolidate that and post the answers in that particular page, answers provided page. So you can do classification, like for the questions posted by RC1103, the following answers were provided. For the questions provided by posted by some other RC, these solutions were provided. So you can do a classification. It is strictly up to you. What I would recommend is that you share a Google Drive or a Google document with each participant and try to consolidate all the answers that are being provided across the week. What are the activities to be performed in Moodle? See, any technology or any activity, make sure that it has the features or the affordances that are required to achieve a learning objective. So there aren't any hard and fast rule. Any activity or technology that can help you in achieving learning objectives, please select those and go ahead. And make sure that it is, the technology or strategy is viable within your operating context. So if students do not have internet connection, giving lot of activities in the internet may not be a feasible idea, or else you will have to make alternative arrangements where they are given a lab session within your college. Okay, so there is a question that, are we supposed to log out from the classroom and proceed to lab? Yes, please go ahead. I am just giving clarification. If one of you want to stay and note down all the clarification that I am providing, do that. So that would be a better strategy. So people who are having labs in separate rooms, please go ahead to the lab and continue with the lab activity. We'll be winding down the sessions in another 5 minutes once I answer most of the questions that are coming in the questions tab. So there is a question, for OER, is it necessary to have members from same RC? It is not required. So ideally select it from the same cohort. The only limitation that we are putting is that select from same cohort, have similar interests. So when you create educational resources, it is always convenient if you, both of you have shared interests. So if you are from the same domain, it would help you to create an educational resource for the domain. Or if you want a generic open educational resource, then feel free to collaborate with the others. A detailed instruction on this will be sent via email tomorrow. Please do not worry regarding open educational resource, team formation and other things. Both the mentors and mentees will be sent an email from course support giving you exact clarity on OER team formation. So there's a question, we use Clicker app for active learning assignment. How can we configure Clicker app in Android mobile? Is there any guideline doc to set up Clicker? Please share with us. Really depends on which kind of clickers you are using. But if any remote center are extensively using. Okay, this question is from RC1057. I'm not really aware of any separate guideline document, but wherever you have purchased the clickers, if you can see whether they have a user manual or a document, that would be the best way to go about it. Clicker in mobiles. So there is another app called Plickers, Plickers. It would be worthwhile investigating how that works. That is also doable in mobile. Okay. So there is a very practical question that has been raised by VNIT Nagpur. So the question is, for RCA in FTP 101X, there is a possibility that the websites may get updated over a period of time, and the reviewer's review may not actually reflect on the reviewer might have reviewed on the basis of some earlier version of the website, and the participant would have modified the website at a later point of time. Yes, this is a very valid review. This is a very valid question. We will definitely look into this aspect of it, and maybe we will try to look at some mechanism through which we will be able to access the site updates and other things. So we can always ask the users to provide us with the site updates for the WordPress, the site update logs, which will have a more information on when the site was updated. But we will definitely look into the various ways in which this is actually implemented. So as of now, the mentors are actually in the process of reviewing these queries. So once the mentors provide us the consolidated review, then we will take a call on the changes and other things. So yes, this is a valid question. We'll definitely try to address it in a more systematic manner. So this is from RC1148. What all help we may receive through mentors? Is there any responsibility manual? This is a wonderful idea, the responsibility manual. So what we'll do is, before the interaction that is happening, I think even the mentors, so the mentors have also been asking us to give guideline manuals. So what we'll do is, we'll put up all these instructions for FTP 201X and share to you by this Thursday, where we'll clearly define the roles of mentors, particularly in this particular FTP. We will look at what each mentor can give and the ways in which they can address the queries and clarifications. Most of the other queries that have been posted in the questions tab, I think I have addressed. Valchand Institute, can you provide videos or materials so that resource creation will be more easy? Example, quiz on Moodle. So while at least representative sample, we will try to provide some videos and resources. I'll also share the previous the top performers website that people can look in when they have a doubt regarding specific open educational resource. So we'll have a list of WordPress websites that participants can go and look at. And since most of the top performers have done a variety of open educational resources last time, we will have a lot of these documents that will be available in their WordPress website. So I think I have answered most of the queries, because I see a lot of greens here at the bottom. So in case there are more queries, please post those in Padlet. What I'll do is, every day I'll be coming online in Padlet for 1 hour. So this is something known as office hours. So tomorrow, between 2 and 3 p.m., I'll come online in Padlet and I'll create a post where I'll say office hours. So what you can do is, I'll be creating a post called office hours. So you can come on that and you can ask all your queries. Or I think a better idea is, I'll create a specific Padlet for office hours. I think that is better, rather than coming to the same Padlet. So I'll create a new Padlet for office hours, and that link will be shared to everyone via email tomorrow morning. So once this Padlet is created, tomorrow I'll be available over there between 2 and 3 p.m. So you can post your queries in this Padlet, which has not been addressed till now, in this Padlet, and I'll answer each of your queries. So if I'll be logging in using my personal login. So you can see my name along with the answers and other comments. So in case people want to explore Padlet in mobile, so there is a mobile app for Padlet. People who have Android mobile phones, just go to your Play Store and search Padlet. So what I'm going to do is, so just see this particular. So in the Google Play Store, you will see this particular app. So essentially the idea is I'll be creating a new Padlet for office hours through my mobile, so that between 2 and 3 we can interact. So all the queries I'll be able to address in the Padlet web page. So I'll be creating a new Padlet and I'll be sharing the office hours Padlet to all of you via email today itself. I'll be sending out a mass email from course support. Okay, so institutes who are having queries, please note that we'll be updating all these instructions in an email and we'll be sending to all of you. So you can all continue doing the lab activity. The lab assignment quiz will be released tomorrow afternoon. The lab activities you can continue doing till this Sunday. The lab assignment quiz will also have a duration till this Sunday. So that's it from IIT Bombay for this synchronous interaction. We hope that you would have got an idea about active learning and how tools can be used effectively for leveraging teaching learning process. Over the coming weeks, you will be doing a lot of these flipped classroom activity design using active learning strategies. And there will also be the larger open educational resource creation activity, which will start from week 3. We do understand that there is a tremendous workload for many of the teachers during this time. So we will be definitely considering, at least for open educational resource, we will definitely consider to extend the deadline a little more. So maybe we may give around 10 to 12 days for creation of the open educational resource and another 10 to 12 days for review of the open educational resource. So please do not worry about deadlines or other activities. And regarding certificate of FDP 101, once both the FDPs are over, the certificates will be dispatched from IIT Bombay to all the participants. So if suppose a participant completed FDP 101X and was unable to complete FDP 201X, do not worry, you will get the certificate for FDP 101X. So a big thanks to the video team and the workshop team who have been helping me out in the entire 2 days interaction. Also thank Professor Fatak, Dr. Samir, Professor Sahanamurthy and Professor Sridhar Iyer, who gave us valuable insights regarding the active learning process. And I thank all the participants, all the individuals who have turned up during this weekend, without whom this interaction would not have been possible. So thank you all, thank you one and all from my heart. And that's it from IIT Bombay. Bye for now. Thank you.